Hello there. Let's start our second, in fact, third program on resonance. The second one was the discussion on assignment. That was also incomplete. Today we'll be doing that. While we'll be taking off that, yesterday's assignment discussion, we'll be also applying our knowledge, which one will contribute more, which one will contribute less. So that we will be doing at the end. Let us first complete, maybe within 45 minutes, I think we can complete the 10 rules. Can you tell me, can you remind me, what are the 5 basic patterns to locate where you write resonance structures, where you find there is a conjugation? And you can draw at least one more resonance structure. I told you the 5 basic rules, I mean basic patterns. The first pattern is allylic carbocation. And the second pattern, pi bond between two electronegative, between two different atoms having different electronegativities. Third pattern, positive charge next to a lone pair. And the fourth pattern is the 2 arrow mark pattern. The first 3 will involve 1 arrow mark and the fourth one will involve 2 arrow marks. What is that pattern? We can call it allylic lone pair or allylic like lone pair. A lone pair next to a pi bond. If it is a carbon-carbon pi bond, then it is perfectly an allylic system and where you have to use 2 arrow mark. But if it is an allyl-like system, you can use, but you better have 2 resonance structures, each with 1 arrow mark pattern. Pattern 2 followed by pattern 3, so that you will not miss one. Although today we shall see the middle one will contribute less to the hybrid, but it does contribute, so you cannot miss it. Although relatively it has the least contribution, because I remind you, if you polarize first the pi bond, carbonyl pi bond, and make a plus minus, the number of pi bonds is reduced. Immediately the number of pi bonds is reduced. So today we shall take a rule, learn a rule. If the number of pi bonds is less in a RS, that is unstable, less stable, I'm sorry, and will contribute less to the hybrid. So relatively that will not contribute more. It will contribute less, but it will contribute. So today's program is resonance structures and the relative stabilities. The relative stabilities and hence the relative contributions. That will be known if you just divide into 2 categories. The first category is equivalent resonance structures. Such cases are very, very limited. In organic chemistry, you will not find the resonance structures are equivalent. The cases are very rare, but you must know if the contribution, I mean the resonance structures are equivalent, then their contributions are also equivalent. Either divided by 2 or divided by 3, depending on the number of contributing structures, you can divide. Take a number average of bond order, also number average of the charge, whatever. So when a conjugating, how do you know that the resonance structures are equivalent? When the conjugating units are structurally symmetrical with respect to the central atom and the RSS carry same number of pi bonds, same number of lone pairs, if at all there is an unpaired electron, if it is a radical, free radical, then same number of unpaired electrons, same charge, same amount of charge, if at all it is a charged species, then they are equivalent. First of all, structurally it should be equivalent. Symmetrical with respect to the central atom in the conjugated system. with respect to the central atom, one side is O, the other side has to be O. If one side is O, the other side is N, then even if the number of pi bonds, number of lone pairs, number of amount of charge remains the same, then also there will be unequal stability and unequal contribution. If the structure is exactly symmetrical with respect to the central atom, the peripheral atoms are identical, then you count the number of pi bonds same, number of lone pairs same, charge same, then you say the two are equivalent. You can just identify, once you look at it, I will tell you, you will identify the pattern, the structures to be identical or equivalent or non-equivalent. If they are equivalent and there are two RSS, then the delocalization is how many percentage? 50%. So it is a very high delocalization, high stability, greater stability. Even if there are two RSS, but since the two are equivalent, the contributions are equal, 50%. So the delocalization of the electrons, delocalization of the charge, if any, will also be high, 50%. In such case, the bond order is exactly the number average of all the bonds at a particular site. If there is a charge, then it is equally shared between the charge center. The examples are allyl carbocation and allyl carbanion. Allyl carbanion. Allyl carbanion. Carboxylate ion, nitroalkane, and in inorganic area, carbonate ion, nitrate ion, nitrite ion, these will have symmetrical RSS, equivalent RSS. For example, carboxylate ion, which is the conjugating part, this, not R. R does not belong to the conjugated system. This, three atoms. Carbon is the central atom, this O, and this side also O. And then the number of pi bonds are same. This side, in this case, this side, in this case, upper side. But the number of pi bonds are same, number of lone pairs are same, and above all, the structure is symmetrical with respect to the central atom. Then only, this is a different category, equivalent RSS. If the equivalent RSS, you find the RSS are equivalent, then they contribute to the extent of 50%, and hence you can dare share the charge into two parts, minus half, minus half. This is the hybrid, and the bond order will be exactly 1.5. 2 plus 1, the total number of bonds at a particular site is 3 here, divided by 2. So the bond order is 1.5 in each case. So also in case of benzene, is a hybrid of two Kekulé resonance structures. So here also the bond order is exactly 3 by 2, 1.5, and the extent of delocalization is very high. Similarly, allyl carbocation, these two are equivalent. So you can write plus half, plus half. Yes or no? Because the number of pi bonds, number of, the amount of charge, and structure-wise it is symmetrical. So these two are equivalent. But if there is a slight difference, supposing I will put a methyl group here, then one will be a secondary carbocation, the other one will be a primary carbocation. In that case, they will not be equivalent and they will not contribute equally to the hybrid. Right? Only when this case is very, very limited and rare. And in that case, I told you, the bond order is exactly the number average, total number of bonds at a particular position by total number of resonance structures. And partial charge at each charge center is equal to total charge by the number of resonance structures. That you know. But our focus is on non-equivalent resonance structures, which are abundant, replete in organic chemistry. The case of equivalent RSS is very, very rare and limited, but the case of unequal, non-equivalent RSS is replete, is abundant. So let us learn the 10 basic rules which will give you an idea which one you will consider contributing more to the hybrid and which one less to the hybrid and which one is totally insignificant. You can dare omit it or delete it from your list. You shall be knowing that. Before that, let me read out. Non-equivalent resonance structures have different relative stabilities and contribute unequally to the hybrid. The more stable resonance structure contributes more to the hybrid. In such case, the hybrid is not a number average. It is a weighted average of all the RSS, not the number average. The one which is contributing more, the hybrid will be resembling more to that, not to others. Right? If a particular hybrid animal between two entities, say horse and donkey, if the horse character is 90%, then from a distance, that hybrid animal will be looking almost similar to horse rather than donkey. But if it is 50-50, then yes, you cannot make out. You have to take some time to distinguish whether it's not a donkey, not a horse, so in between. But if one of them contributes almost exclusively, the other one is to a very small extent, and from a distance, you can say that the hybrid is resembling more closely to the one which is predominating in contribution, which has a dominant contribution to the hybrid. Yes. In such case, the bond order and bond length in such case change to a lesser extent in this case. You understand what I said? Although there will be 3-4 RSS, but since out of 3, 2 will have smaller contribution to the hybrid, then the extent of delocalization is small and hence the stability is less. And therefore, in the hybrid, the change in bond order is not much, is less. If the double bond, the RS having double bond is contributing to the extent of 80%, then the hybrid, the bond order will be 1.8. Yes or no? And single bond will be maybe 1. Supposing you have a situation like this, what I am wanting to tell you. Supposing you have a situation like this. So you apply which pattern? Pattern. Tell me pattern number. It's very strange. It's very strange. You have practiced so extensively and you are not able to answer. Pattern? Oh my God. Is there any positive charge next to lone pair? Pattern 4, it is an allylic system. Lone pair adjacent to a double bond, pi bond. Lone pair next to a pi bond. So that belongs to pattern 4. I am really surprised how you could not detect this pattern. So you draw this one. So that you get another contributing structure where nitrogen will have plus charge and that this double bond will be here and this will be having minus charge. Yes or no? But if we know that one is contributing much greater than two, say 80% contribution comes from one, 20% contribution comes from two. So the resonance hybrid, you draw no doubt an CS2 and draw dotted line. Throughout there will be bond order will be changed. Neither double bond nor single bond. Here also neither single bond nor double bond. But tell me, and the charge will be shared. This will be minus, it will be minus delta. This is plus, this will be what? Plus delta. But carbon-carbon bond order, will it be 1.5 or more than 1.5? More than 1.5, because the double bond contribution is more, the single bond contribution is less, because we shall know from one rule that this is a ionic RS, there is a charge separation, and here there is no charge separation. We shall be applying the rule and say that this is an unstable RS, I mean less stable, not unstable, less stable RS, and hence contribute less. Therefore, had the two, ISA, had the two been equivalent, then exactly bond order would have been 1.5, 1.5. But since the two are non-equivalent and this contributes less, this contributes more, so the hybrid resembles more closely to RS1. And in RS1, it is a double bond. Therefore, this changed order will not be very much different from 2. It will be closer to 2, not closer to 1, or not even the middle. 1.5 also, it's not 1.5. It will be greater than 1.5. Why? Double bond character will be more. This RS is contributing more. So here the bond order will change, no doubt, but not to the extent that would have been changed had there been two equivalent RSs. Had there been two equivalent RSs, then exactly number average, this is also 1.5, this is also 1.5. But since the two are unequal, the two are non-equivalent, they contribute unequally, this contributes more, this contributes less, and therefore this will have a greater double bond character. No doubt, but the fact that the bond order has been reduced from 2, that's the success story of resonance. Yes or no? The resonance theory only can tell that the actual bond order is not 2 because of delocalization, because of conjugation, resonance. The bond order has been changed. For this, it is less than 2, and for this, greater than? No! Greater than 1. Focus yourself, because I am conducting this for the purpose of recording. I can't while away the time to make it unnecessarily long. So unless you focus it, you will be missing. And I also not gain the same amount of satisfaction had I done it in the absence of the students. There, I do feel I have a greater freedom to interact with the camera. This structure, somebody tells you this structure. If you do not know anything about resonance, you will say this carbon-carbon is a double bond, bond order 2. Carbon-nitrogen is a single bond, bond order 1. But actually this is a conjugated system. There is another contributing structure, however less contributing it may be. Because of that, this acquires slightly less order than 2. This acquires slightly greater order than 1 because of the contribution of the double bond character. But since the contribution of 2 is less, this bond order, though more than 1, but much less than 2, even less than 1.5. So this bond order, the actual bond order of carbon-carbon, is definitely less than 2. Cannot be 2 because of the contribution of the single bond character. It is less than 2, but it is not less than 1.5. It is more than 1.5, but less than 2. So that is only explained because of conjugation, resonance, or mesomerism. Resonance is also called mesomerism, particularly in some most restricted cases. I will tell you when later. Then the third, fourth line, if the charge is unequally, and therefore the charge, if any, is also unequally shared between the charge centers. You can't write plus up. You can't write minus half, you can't write plus 2, minus 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3 like carbonate ion. You can't do that because they are non-equivalent. Therefore, you have to distribute the charge unequally. Therefore, you write plus delta or minus delta plus delta. In terms of delta, you do not know the exact percentage of contribution, nobody can calculate. You can say which is dominating in its contribution, which has a less stable, which has a less contributing RS, and which is totally insignificant RS. You can discard it. That you can do, but you can't estimate quantitatively what is the percentage of contribution. The hybrids resemble more closely to the most contributing RS, though others do contribute. Others are not sitting silent. They are contributing, and that for that reason, the main hero is getting changed. The main hero is getting changed. The bond order is getting changed. However small it may be, it is getting changed. Sometimes a RS may be totally insignificant or invalid and contributes almost nothing to the hybrid. When? If it is highly unstable. We will know in which cases it will be highly unstable. If the structure is unsymmetrical, how will you know the structure is unsymmetrical? With respect to central atom or the number of pi bonds, number of lone pairs, number of amount of charge are unequal, then RSS are non-equivalent. If structure wise it is unsymmetrical, it is definitely the RSS are non-equivalent. Even if the structure wise it is symmetrical, but the number of pi bonds are changing. Here it is 3 pi bonds, here it is 2 pi bonds, there it is 1 pi bond. That case also it will have different stabilities and hence different contributions to the hybrid, right? Then let us one by one list the rules of assessing the relative contribution, relative stability and hence contribution of the non-equivalent what? RSS. Till now what we learnt? That if the 2 or 3 or 4 RSS are non-equivalent, then they contribute unequally to the hybrid. And therefore, the hybrid is not a number average of the RSS. It is a weighted average. The one which contributes maximum will be found to a greater extent in the hybrid. Rule number one, more the number of pi bonds or covalent bonds, more is the stability. Sigma bond will never change. So more the number of pi bonds means more is the number of covalent bonds. Sigma bond will never change. Sigma bond skeleton will remain the same. So more is the number of pi bonds, more is the stability and hence more is the contribution. Now tell me between these three of this is diazomethane. This is a lone pair here, this is a lone pair with a minus charge, and here it is plus, this is a triple bond, and once I delocalize this lone pair, this pi bond is delocalized, and there are two lone pairs, negative charge comes here, and plus charge remains the same, and there is a double bond here. And if I polarize this using pattern 2, if I polarize this, then plus, and this plus charge is it discharged. Yes or no? There was a plus charge initially and that is discharged here, and there is a minus charge here, plus charge here. So tell me, out of these three, which is to be totally neglected? Third, this one has to be totally ignored. Why? Because in 1 and 2, the number of pi bonds is 2. Here is a triple bond, there are 2 pi bonds, and there are 2 double bonds, 1 pi bond each. So number of pi bonds are equal. So in this case, this it cannot compete with these two. The number of pi bonds has been reduced. So less is the number of pi bonds, less is the stability. So RS3 is much less stable and is insignificant, invalid. We never write this one. For diazomethane, we write only these two. Why we ignore this? Although we can apply, you know, pattern 2, we can apply. Today we are learning, even if you apply a pattern, out of the 5 patterns may apply. But you can say which one you will be just ignoring, just deleting, or you will keeping. It is a valid RS but contributing less. But because of the contribution, the overall bond order is changing. However small change it may be. So you ignore this. About RS 1 and 2 we will discuss later. Just after some time we have another rule. So I will ask you the rules. There yesterday I was asking 5 rules and 5 patterns. Now I will be asking 10 different rules for assessing relative stability and hence contribution. This is number of pi bonds. First, you have to count the number of pi bonds. You can jot down so that it will be easy for our revision purpose. Number one, number of pi bonds. Only right number of pi bonds. More is the number of pi bonds, more is the stability. Khali just right number of pi bonds. Rule 2. Now have a look. For neutral molecule, the RS having charge separation is less stable than the RS without it. That means we used to say that non-ionic RS is more stable than the ionic RS for a neutral molecule. Or aisa, for a neutral molecule, the RS having charge separation is less stable than the RS having no charge separation. For example, here, as we used to do, ignoring the second one, we have missed one RS, okay? We have missed one RS, we have adopted the two arrow method and not successive one arrow mark, but we have missed that, doesn't matter. Whatever I have shown you, out of these two, the carboxylic acid, RC double bond OH, you will find this one is a neutral RS, but this is an ionic RS, where there is a charge separation, here is a plus charge, here is a minus charge. So this charge separation within a neutral molecule is not allowed. They will definitely try to overlap and form a chargeless entity. So if you do that, then that will contribute less. So which RS is more stable? RS2 is much less stable than RS1, but it is a valid one. It is a valid one. You can't invalidate it. It is a valid one, but its contribution is very less because there has been a charge separation. The molecule as a whole is neutral, but you have polarized the charge. I mean, you have polarized the pi bond and there is a charge separation, plus minus. And in the hybrid, we have left one. Who can tell me where the plus delta should also be given? Because we have missed one RS, we have missed also plus delta in another center. Where is that? Here, here. Because I have written two, missed one, therefore I have not written plus delta here. Rule number 3. What was rule number 2? For a neutral molecule, non-ionic RS is more stable than the ionic RS. Then 3. More than 2 charges, charge sites in RSS make it insignificant. More than 2. Supposing there are 3 charge centers. 3, 4. Totally invalid. Even the magnitude of each charge being greater than 2. 2 or above is also makes the RS invalid. So neither there will be more than 2 charge centers nor the magnitude of at each charge point should be more than 2. 2 or more than 2. It should be less than 2. The charge separation in a dative bond, this is very important, is not counted. If you find a dative bond, there is a donor and acceptor and you give a thermal charge plus for the donor and minus for the acceptor. In that case, you do not count that charge. You don't count 2. The number of charge centers is 2. You have to totally discount that dative bond as a charge center. For example, now see, you have a look here. Tell me why I will invalidate this. Not a valid RS. Why? Now, had it been acetone, then it is not invalid. But here there is already a charge. It is a carbanion. It's not acetone, it is a carbanion, conjugate base of acetone. So there, if I write this, if I do this, then I plus, minus, minus. Then how many charge centers are there? Three. It's not allowed. More than 2 charge centers is totally unacceptable because that destabilizes this RS and hence the contribution is insignificant. So you can just ignore that contribution. Therefore, for such a species, you can't apply rule number 2 and then rule number 3. You cannot. You have to go for a 2 arrow mark pattern. Pattern 4 you have to adopt. Come here and come there. So these there are only 2. But had it been acetone, then that is a valid, I mean plus, minus, and then again. Had it been a situation like this OR, is not a charge center, then you can do. You can polarize, you apply, pattern 2, get plus minus, and then pattern 3 to get plus here and double bond here. But if there is a charged minus charge here, you cannot write plus here, minus here, minus here, 3, not acceptable, okay? So this is not acceptable. Therefore, this is acceptable. Only 2, not 3. I am not missing anyone. Why I am not missing anyone? Why I cannot apply rule, pattern 2 here, only using one arrow mark first and then more than? Yes, I will be getting more than 2 charge sites. More than 2 charge sites is unacceptable in any RS. Therefore, I cannot use pattern 2 to make it plus minus. And then I will apply pattern 3 to get it this. So this middle one is unacceptable. Why it is unacceptable? Because here is a minus charge, here is a plus charge, here is a minus charge. That is why I cannot use pattern 2 here in this case. But in which case I would have used pattern 2 and then pattern 3? If there would have no charge. If there would have no charge here, then I would first apply pattern 2. I can get plus minus, however less stable it may be, as we shall know. But we can do that. Then rule number and see another example. Why I cannot polarize this? I cannot use, in particular this species, I cannot use pattern 2 to polarize this plus minus. I cannot do. Minus charge is missing here. Why? Because how many charges? 3. So too many charges, more than 2 is not acceptable. Therefore, if somebody asks you to draw any RS possible, then only you have to apply pattern 2 here. There is a pi bond between two atoms. So pattern 2 is applied plus here and this will be neutralized. This will be plus. So this is the only contributing structure of this, not this one. This one is almost invalid. We do not consider this. Why? Too many charge. More than 2 charge sites are not acceptable. So how many points gone? How many minutes gone? 33. Oh my God. Okay. Now tell me why I told you that dative bond in nitroalkane or nitroalkene, whatever, this NO is a dative bond. As you used to put a arrow mark. For an ordinary student, the arrow mark is actually plus minus. The donor gets plus charge and the acceptor gets minus charge. So this charge separation is not considered. And since I cannot polarize, I cannot apply pattern 2 here, it will be 2 plus. 2 plus is not also acceptable. So I have to go for a 2 arrow mark pattern. The pattern 4, directly pattern 4. So this. So you will say 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 charge sites, so let us ignore this. No. This one is not counted. Which one? The dative bond is present here, also present here. So for that, the number of charge sites is not counted. But yes, if it is 2 plus, then we definitely count the magnitude of charge and say, so that one we cannot apply first pattern 2 and then pattern 1, because it will be an allylic carbocation. Yes or no? That we cannot do for this particular nitro compounds. We cannot do. We apply the 2 arrow mark pattern 4, so that we get this and we do not count this charge separation. Only say the number of charge sites is how many? 2. Not these 2, not counted. So that in the hybrid you get a partial double bond throughout the conjugated system, and here is this plus delta, here is minus delta. This plus minus remains the same. It's not plus delta here at all, because we have discounted to apply the pattern 2 first. Therefore, there will be no plus delta correct. This plus minus is for the dative bond. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I have shown why pattern 2 is not applied first, because it will be 2 plus. Too many charge and more charge than 2, magnitude 2, they are not allowed. Invalid because higher charge magnitude. Too many charge sites and greater magnitude than 2. Even 2 and greater, that are not applicable. Rule number 4, how many rules gone?
3.
Tell me, what are the 3?
More number of pi bonds.
First you have to look if certain RS is having less number of pi bonds, rejected. I mean, say that it is contributing less. Then, non-ionic, ionic, in a neutral molecule. Yes, in a neutral molecule, non-ionic, no, less contributing. And third, more than 2 charge centers, not acceptable. And 2 or more magnitude of charge is also not acceptable. Rule number 4, in neutral molecule, the atoms having octet configuration is more stable. Conversely, the atoms having less than octet makes the RS less stable. So the atoms should ideally attain octet configuration, 8 electrons in its valence shell. Of course, if it is a third periodic element like phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, it can expand its valence state because it has back and d orbital, so it can expand, still it will be stable. But I am talking of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine belonging to the second period, they cannot exceed 8. If 8, it is stable. If 6, it is less stable but valid if that plus charge is located on a carbon atom. If the plus charge is located on nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine or any other electronegative atom but having sextet, is invalid. So, I have written here, this is very important. RS with sextet carbon is a valid RS. It is less stable, but a valid. You can't ignore, cut it. But, however, RS with a sextet nitrogen, an electronegative atom having a plus charge. If it is a sextet, means, Ankita, it would definitely have a plus charge. So, a plus charge on nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and a sextet configuration, unacceptable, makes the RS invalid. The RS with sextet carbon is valid, but RS with sextet nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and other electronegative atom is invalid. Next. Rule number. Now see, I have given example. Tell me, this is an alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. We apply pattern 2 first. To make it plus minus, it is valid. Carbon plus is valid. It is having sextet, but carbon, it is valid. But these two are ionic, this is non-ionic. Definitely these two contribute less than the first one. The first one is dominating in its contribution, but 2 and 3, they do contribute. But out of these two, you will know shortly in another rule which one is more contributing, because the number of pi bonds is same. One pi bond. Here there are 2 pi bonds. Here there is a 1 pi bond, and moreover there is a charge separation. Yes or no? So it has 2 demerits. What are the 2 demerits in these two? Number of pi bonds is less than the original one, and as well there is a charge separation. This is a neutral molecule, there is a charge separation. But my interest now is to say that carbon is a sextet, but still it is a valid RS. It is not an invalid RS. But can you make this RS valid? We were doing. Supposing from this there is a positive charge next to a pi bond. So if you say it is an allylic carbocation, it's not an allylic carbocation. If you by chance, you know, polarize this pi bond and bring it here, can it give a stable or any valid RS? Forget about stability. Just talk about validity. It is a valid RS. Why it is not valid RS? Because oxygen is having a plus charge and a and a sextet, six electrons. If the pi bond will come here, then oxygen will be having a sextet. 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6. So it is absolutely not valid. Such a RS is not valid. But why these are valid? But here carbon is plus. Carbon plus is valid. But which plus is invalid? Electronegative atom, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, fluorine, all that with plus charge is provided it is sextet. Provided it is, but if it is an octet with plus charge, it is stable. More stable than carbon is having a sextet. I told you several times. Oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine or whatever, having a plus charge, but octet is more stable than carbon having a sextet. Have a look. Rule number 5. That is the rule number 5. Electronegative atom like O, N, chlorine, etc. having a positive charge but with an octet is more stable than a positive charge on carbon atom and having a sextet. That is a carbocation. Conversely, electronegative atoms such as nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, etc. can bear a positive charge only if they possess an octet. This is the sentence I am borrowing from David Klein, but my sentence is this. Electronegative atom like O and chlorine having positive charge with an octet is more stable than a positive charge on carbon with a sextet. Though it is a valid one, but it is not more stable than electronegative. Some people, Ankita, say that since O and N are more electronegative, how can it sustain a positive charge? But you are forgetting that that is an octet. Carbon is a sextet. So while comparing between the stability octet and sextet stability, and oxygen carrying a plus charge and carbon carrying a plus charge, the you know there is a mismatch. Oxygen having a plus charge and an octet has more stability and more contribution than carbon having a sextet. So now let me give you an example. Out of these two, when there is a plus charge, applying pattern 3. Yes or no? This is pattern 3, plus charge next to a lone pair. So out of the two, which is more stable and more contributing? Never say it is one. People say it is two, which is less stable, less contributing. Why? Oxygen is carrying plus. No. Oxygen is having octet. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus lone pair 2. So, hey, and this is a carbocation sextet. So, 2 is more stable than 1. Right? Then, rule number 6. If there is a charge on an atom or there is a charge separation. Listen, Arpita. If there is a charge separation or there is a charge on the atom, this you know, then the negative charge is more stable if it occupies in a more electronegative atom like oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, preferably oxygen, then nitrogen, then carbon. And if there is a positive charge, is more stable if it lies on a less electronegative atom, just the opposite. Just the opposite. Negative charge will be more stabilized in oxygen, less stabilized in carbon. But positive charge is more stabilized in carbon, least stabilized in oxygen. And down a group, the negative charge is more stable in a bigger size atom. Because more is the size of the atom, more is its polarizability. So, the negative charge will be diffused, delocalized to a greater extent. So, it is more stable. So, down the group, size comes into picture. But within a period, more is the electronegativity that stabilizes a negative charge. Less is the electronegativity that relatively stabilizes a what? More is the electronegativity, it stabilizes a negative charge more. And less is the electronegativity, it stabilizes a positive charge relatively more. But no doubt if it is a sextet, it is definitely unstable. But if it is an octet, then definitely it will be more and more stable if it occupies in a less electronegative atom. You don't ask me a question, in that case, why carbon plus is becoming less stable than oxygen plus, but that carbon plus is a sextet. If octet remains the same, then a plus charge is more stable in carbon rather than in oxygen. Negative charge is more stable in oxygen rather than in carbon. But you can't say carbon has a plus charge is less stable than oxygen having plus charge. It is just because this oxygen having plus charge is an octet, but this carbon having plus charge is a sextet. Are you following me? Now see, I'm showing you this. This is phenoxide, the conjugate base of phenol has this four RSS. The fifth one we draw only to have a practice, but this is a RS of benzene ring, not phenoxide ion. This you applied pattern 3-2 arrow program, not this is an allyl system, perfectly an allyl system. You cannot have one arrow mark first. Carbon-carbon pi bond cannot be polarized independently. So two arrow mark, then two arrow mark, then two arrow mark. So successively two arrow mark patterns are to be followed. And in that case, tell me why RS1 is independently more contributing, more stable than each of the 2, 3, 4. Why? Because the negative charge here is located on oxygen atom. Here it is located in a less electronegative carbon atom. But all of them are octet. Nowhere there is a deviation of octet, but still there is a negative charge in carbon, here carbon, here carbon, here carbon, but here oxygen. Therefore, this dominates. To the hybrid, the contribution of first one is much more than this, right? Another example. Tell me this we have already rejected. Why you have rejected this? In the face of these two, the number of pi bonds is less. Out of the two where the number of pi bonds are same, that case tell me compare between these two. Here negative charge lying on a less electronegative carbon atom. Here the negative charge is lying on a more electronegative nitrogen atom. So definitely two is more stable and more contributing than one. Rule 7. We are shortly finishing this program. We'll take a break and then apply for solving problems. Rule 7 for RSS having charge separation, if unlike charges are closer, then it is more stable than the RS in which unlike charges are far away from each other. If it is definitely a polar, I mean, you have to make a charge separation. There is no way out. There has to be a charge separation. In that case, if the opposite charges lie side by side, in adjacent atoms, it is more stable than the opposite charges lying in farther away from each other, right? Because they will attract and they will have a tendency to overlap and form a bond and stabilize, rather than the one, the positive, negative are farther away, they have no chance for any overlap, so that unstable. So tell me, conversely, if the like charges are closer to each other, then it is more unstable, and if the like charges are farther away from each other, it is more stable. Now see, I am applying this case first pattern 2, making plus minus, then allylic pattern, this is pattern 1, then getting third. Now tell me, out of 2 and 3, why 2 and 3 are less stable than 1? Because this is non-ionic, these two are ionic. Now between 2 and 3, both of which contain one pi bond, between 2 and 3, relatively which one is more stable and more contributing?
Two.
Why 2? Because the plus minus charge are close to each other. Here you see plus charge and minus charge, they are close to each other. And here minus charge and plus charge are farther away from each other. So in such a case, you will find that the RS in which the opposite charges are closer to each other is more stable. So between 2 and 3, 2 is relatively more stable than 3. But 1 out of all these 3 is most dominating and most contributing. Yes or no? So 1 much greater than 2 and 3. 2 is greater than 3. Why 2 is greater than 3? Because the opposite charges are nearer to each other. Right. Let us go to rule number 8. Which you already know, that carbon-carbon double bond can never be polarized to form an ionic RS. That means in a perfect allele system, you cannot first apply pattern 2 and then pattern 3. Is it not a perfect allele system? Carbon-carbon double bond is there, and lone pair next to a carbon-carbon double bond is a perfect allele system. You cannot first polarize the pi bond and make it plus minus and then polarize this. I mean lone pair next to a positive charge and get the third. No, this one will be completely ruled out. Why it will be ruled out? Carbon-carbon pi bond cannot, it's a non-polar, so it cannot be polarized. And if at all in any RS you find this, you reject it. It is last. So in an advanced level test, you are given 4 or 5 RS for a particular species. Number of random changes they will be making. The question setter will be making random changes in the structure. So first you will find the number of pi bonds. If the pi bonds are less, then it is less stable. Then you will find that oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine having a sextet rejected. And this carbon-carbon double bond is polarized fast, rejected. So in such case, you have to apply the allylic 2 RMR pattern and get only 2 RSS, right? Not that here plus delta, here minus delta, and here plus delta. Only minus delta here and plus delta here. Yes? Arpita, got it? Then rule number 9. If RSS are carbocations, then the stability order you know. 3 degree greater than 2 degree greater than 1 degree. If all the RSS are carbocations, then you have to look to the relative stabilities. Have a look to this case. This is allyl pattern 1. So when you bring these 2 electrons here, plus charge now comes to a secondary position. So it is a 2 degree carbocation, this is a 1 degree carbocation. So RS2 is more stable, this is 2 and this is 1. So RS2 is more stable and more contributing than RS1. Yes or no? Because RS2 is secondary carbocation. The order you know. Then last but not the least, if any RS is aromatic, then has unusually high stability and contribution. I think I did mention to you yesterday, if one of the RS is an aromatic structure, about aromaticity, you forget about, just wait for few more days, you will know what is aromaticity. So this is an aromatic pattern, 3 double bonds and there is a plus charge here, this is an aromatic pattern. So because of this, the tropon, this compound is called tropon, has a 99.99% contribution of this and almost negligible contribution of this structure. Therefore, for all practical purposes, we take tropon as this, is an aromatic compound, plus and minus. Just like benzene ring, this is a 7-membered ring, but benzene is a 6-membered ring, but there are 6 pi electrons. And the plus charge is there, so it is a ring conjugation takes place like benzene ring, so unusually high stability. So tropon, this RS is almost neglected. This, the contribution is of this is so high that makes the species tropon, everybody tells tropon as an aromatic compound. But if you'd like to take this structure, you cannot say it is aromatic. You cannot say, if you take this structure, you will say it is aromatic. Just because this RS is so very stable, so very highly contributing that the entire species acquires the aromatic character. So for all practical purposes, we call tropon as an aromatic compound. Then the interesting thing comes. What's the time?